Know that God is giving you anybody that's here, that's saved, that's trying to be saved, assign yourself to them. If you see somebody that want to come up high and trying to do right, make them your battle buddy in prayer. See what they need. Some of the benefits of a battle buddy is it reduces the rates of suicide and sexual assaults. This is, I'm talking about in the military. It promotes cooperative problem solving. Battle buddies keep each other informed about key instructions and information. It increases morale. It encourages soldiers and motivates and increases confidence. It decreases stress. A battle buddy eases transition into a military lifestyle. So we can say that a battle buddy will, it'll ease a person. If somebody's a babe in Christ, you go and grab a hold of them. You can ease them into walking into, you know, the household of faith. It improves communication. For those that don't speak the language of salvation, it promotes better leadership skills. If you see somebody that, you know, a sister in the church or a brother in the church that you can uphold in prayer, that's what God is telling us to do in 2016. If you'll turn with me to Galatians 6, 1 and 3. It says, Galatians 6, 1 and 3, it said, brethren, if any man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. For if a man think himself to be something when he's nothing, he deceiving himself. So God is saying right here, if one of your brothers or sisters overtaken in a fault, ye that are spiritual, don't go and try to pull your sister brother out and you ain't in your place yourself. It says, ye that are spiritual, you know, go and pull that person out. Help them to be, you know, get back in their place. And one way that you can do it is in prayer, supplication, fasting for that brother or sister. God put somebody in my heart to pray for and to fast for right before, you know, the beginning of the year. And that's what God is wanting us to do. Get spiritual so that we can get somebody that may be a little bit weak in an area, and we can help build them up in the body of Christ. Turn with me to Romans 15, 1 through 6. Romans 15, 1 through 6. It says, We then that are strong are to bear the infirmities of the weak. So that's what a battle buddy does. If you have somebody that God has placed in your heart that you know are struggling in their walk, I'm not talking about somebody that's trying to go back out and sin, but they really trying to live holy. They really trying to do this thing. He wants us to bear their infirmities, each other's infirmities. It says not to please ourselves. Let every one of us please his neighbor for his good to edification. For even Christ pleased not himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of them that reproach him fell on thee. So sometimes the reproaches of your brothers and sisters need to fall on you or me. We need to be able to bear each other's burdens sometimes. And that's what God is wanting us to do. There's no reason for the church to be scattered in 2016. God wants us to be battle buddies in this thing. If you see your sister or brother that's struggling, go grab them and tell them, come on, you can make it. You can walk this walk out. You know, I can be here. I'll pray with you. I'll fast with you. I'll call on Jesus with you till you feel that Holy Ghost like you first felt it. That's what God is calling us to do in now, 2016, 2015, right now. It says, for whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. Now, the God of patience and consolation grants you to be like-minded toward one another according to Jesus Christ, that ye may with one mind and one mouth glorify God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. So just as the pastor Brandon was saying before, how God, Jesus, he didn't turn nobody away that was trying to get in their place. That's what we got to be. We got to be one-minded, and we got to edify each other. We got to build each other up. We got to be battle buddies in this thing. The enemy is trying to destroy each and every one of us. I don't know if you know it, but the devil tried to take some of us out in 2015. And if you know like I know, you want to get somebody that want to be saved, that want to live holy, that's serious about that walk, and you going to grab them with you, and y'all going to walk this walk and show the enemy that he has no power over a person that has a made up mind. I don't know who my battle buddy is, but I'm going to look in this audience, I'm going to say, you, and you. I'm going to hold you up in prayer. I want you to hold me up in prayer. I want us to fight the enemy, because he's fighting us. another and edify one another, even as also you do. So God know that some of us, we try to build each other up. It's that even as you do. It's that, and we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you and to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake. So that's what we need to be doing. We need to be lifting up our pastor and our lady, the pastors that are trying to live right, trying to do right. We need to be lifting them up in prayer. We need to be fasting for them, fasting for their children to help lighten the load. And it says, and be at peace among yourselves. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient toward all men. See that no one render evil for evil unto any man. Be ever follow that which is good both among yourselves and to all men. So not only for the people that are in the household of faith, but unto all men. We need to be girding our pastor and our lady up in prayer and fasting. We need to talk to those that are unruly. You know, sometimes you got to be that faith and say, sister, now you know that ain't right. You know, even if they don't like what you're saying, even if they don't receive what you're saying, the Bible says that the watchman's going to stand on the wall and he's going to cry loud and he's going to spat not. So sometimes your friend may not want to hear, but you be the one to say, sister, now look, this is what the Bible say. I know you may call me back later on when the Lord finish talking to you. But we got to uproot, or we got to upgird each other, and we got to be each other's battle buddy in this hour. Psalm 82:1-4, it says, God standeth in the congregation of the mighty. He judge among the gods. How long will ye judge unjustly and accept the persons of the wicked, Selah? It says, defend the poor and the fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and needy. Deliver the poor and needy. Rid them out of the hand of the wicked. So that's what we can do together. We can get in this thing. We can buckle ourselves down. And we can uproot everything that the enemy tried to plant in 2015. I know he tried to attack my house. He tried to take some people out that I love. But I stand right here today and I said, the devil's a liar. I'm going to stand in my holy place. I'm going to pray for my sister and brother. I'm going to pray for my pastor. I'm going to pray for the ministry. I'm going to pray for the household of faith. And I'm going to help get somebody out of their rut this year. I'm going to get myself out of my rut. And I'm going to help my sister and brother because I'm going to be somebody's battle buddy this year. My last scripture is Isaiah 1:9-17. Isaiah 1:9-17. It said, except the Lord of hosts have left us a very strong remnant, we should have been in Sodom and Gomorrah, and we should have been like unto Gomorrah. Hear ye the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom, and give ear to the law of our God, ye people of Gomorrah. To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me, said the Lord? I am full of the burnt offering of rams and the fat of fed beasts, and I delight not in the blood of bullocks or lambs or of he goats. When ye come to appear before me, who have required this at your hand to tread my courts? Bring no more vain oblations. Incense is an abomination unto me. The new moons and the Sabbaths and the calling of assemblies, I cannot away with. It is iniquity, even the solemn meeting. Your new moons and your appointed feasts, my soul hateth. They are trouble unto me. I am weary to bear them. And when ye spread forth your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Yea, when ye make many prayers, I will not hear. Your hands are full of blood. It says, wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease from evil, learn to do well, seek judgment, relieve the oppressed, judge the fatherless, and plead for the widow. So the Lord is saying to me in this scripture, he's tired of us getting together in vanity. He's tired of us just getting together just to get together. He's saying he's not accepting those vain ovations. He's not accepting those incense that we're burning and we're not living holy and we're not doing the right thing. God is saying, do what he's saying to do in this hour. Seek justice in the name of Jesus.